Have honest, real, raw, true conversation and prayer with God.
You go down into the water, and when you do, the old person dies. You come up out of the water as a new creation in Jesus Christ.
Hey, welcome to Church Experience. Thank you so much for spending part of your weekend with us. Now is a great time to grab your weeklies and head to your seats if you haven't already, because the service starts in 90 seconds.
I'm here to tell you today that God wants to set you free.
Oh, yeah.
He wants to set you free.
Pursue a relationship with Him. Grow in your walk with Him. Get closer to Him. Spend more time with Him because He's better. If you want your life to get better, then get around the one who is better. Get around Jesus. Get around the one who has power to change and transform your life. Get around the one who has the perfect grace for you and the perfect love for you and the perfect joy for your soul. Listen, He is better.
Church Experience. I am so glad that you are joining us today. We have such an impactful service that we are going to be joining you, and we're going to dive into some great worship. But before we do, I would love to tell you, if you have any prayer requests or comments, you want to get a hold of us, why don't you go ahead and scan that QR code, or you can go to www.churchexperience.tv/connect. And we would love to spend time with you, get to know you, get back to you. Another way, if you want to make sure you always know what's going on, go ahead and hit that subscribe button right there. You don't want to miss it, and you'll know what's going on at all times. But you know what? I am ready to dive into today's worship, so let's do it.
Thank you. Father, Lord, we just thank you for the great things that you have done for us, Father. You have made the impossible possible, and you have made a way for us. And we are just so grateful for you. We stand here and praise you today and every day, Father God. We pray your protection over us, your love, your peace, Father. We pray that this message just hits our hearts right where we need it, and that we can come closer to you, Father. We pray this in your mighty name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's give God a big hand clap. If you can stand for a quick word of prayer, hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, we love you, we magnify you, we adore you. We say that there is no one like you. Your name reigns supreme. God, have your way in this place, God. We welcome you here. We know you're already here, but we invite you just to move how you want to move in the name of Jesus. God, we pray that lives be changed like never before. Heal, deliver, and set free. Hallelujah. Move me out of the way, God. Move through me. Let your spirit fall fresh in this house. In Jesus' name, I pray. Everybody shout, amen.
Amen.
I love y'all so much. Hallelujah. And CE family, can y'all just make some crazy noise? I'm so excited to be in my church experience this morning. I count it as an honor and a privilege to be here. You can be seated. You can be seated. I've been having a blast. Everybody has been so nice and friendly. So give you guys just a big hand clap of praise. Thank you guys so much. You guys' hospitality has been absolutely amazing, off the charts. If you have your Bibles or your iPads, your iPhones, your Androids, let's go to Ephesians chapter 3. Ephesians chapter 3. If you have it, say, I got it. If you need some time, say, hold up 1 second. Give you a couple more seconds just to grab hold of that. Ephesians chapter 3. And it reads, Ephesians 3:20 reads, now unto him that is able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. Just look at your neighbor and say, I've got power. Come on, you guys are a little quiet. Say, I've got power. Come on, look at somebody else, say, you have power too. You have power too. If I were to give this message a title, it would be, it's a faith fight. Just say, it's a faith fight.
It's faith fight.
Come on, say that real loud. It's a faith fight.
It's a faith fight.
Come on, say it one more time. Say, it's a faith fight.
It's a faith fight.
The Bible says we're supposed to fight the good fight of faith. Why is it a good fight? I'm glad you had ex-church experience, because we win. We are victorious.
Hallelujah.
Do I have any Steelers football fans in the house?
I believe
we're close to Pittsburgh. I believe there's some people that love football around here somewhere.
thoughts.
All right.
What do you do when someone's going to cuss? Is it quiet?
Yeah.
So, as much as God has done for us, when we come to church, it ought to be a celebration. We should be running around it. We should be able to say, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Lord, I love you. Thank you for everything that you've done. Thank you for every way that you made. Thank you for every battle that you've won. Let's give God praise right there. It's a faith fight. One of my favorite pastimes is going to the movies. And my favorite type movie is an action movie. Any action hero fans? Anybody love action movies? My favorite action, I guess, superhero of some sort would be Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Okay, wonderful. Right there. I can see anybody on this side, but okay, all right. But I'm a big Spider-Man fan. Okay, Pastor Marcus, why are you such a huge Spider-Man fan? Because Spider-Man is two people. He's not just Spider-Man, but he's also Peter Parker. So one of the things I love about Peter Parker is he's just a practical guy. But when he steps out and realizes that there is a need, there is a boldness that he carries, that the shift from just being the average ordinary Joe and being someone who is a superhero. And I just come to encourage just a couple people at church experience. You're not just average. You're above average. Hallelujah. You're not just natural, but you're supernatural. And God has not given you the spirit of fear, but power, love, and a sound. I got power. So it's no need for me to fear because God has given me faith. And I say faith.
Faith.
Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Everybody say, I got evidence. I'm real low. Okay, all right. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Faith is not just a noun. Faith is not just a thought process. Faith is, until faith becomes action, that's when we're able to see real change take place in our communities. We must have faith. Faith is the technology of heaven. And in times like these that we are living in, we need faith. We need boldness like never before to be able to conquer the challenges that we face on a day-to-day basis. Paul, in this passage, was saying a big prayer. He was calling out to God. Hallelujah. He was saying, Ephesians 3 and 16 really reads, it says, that he would grant you according to the riches of glory to be strengthened with might. Everybody say might. Might by his spirit in the inner man. It didn't say the fleshy man. It said the inner man. So many times we work so much on the outer appearance, but not focus enough. Everybody says the inner man. Come on, we got to focus on the inner man. For the perilous time that we're facing, I know it's good to look nice on the outside. I know we wear makeup, we get our hair done, and we have nice clothes and different things on, and we do things for a nice appearance. But what What does it mean to gain the whole world but lose your soul? I understand you got driving nice cars and living in fancy homes, but we need to be able to have the most important thing that we need in this hour is a closer relationship with the Lord. If you agree with that, say amen.
Amen.
In times like these, we need the power of God. Let me get 2 Timothy 3 and 1 up. 2 Timothy 3 and 1. It's talking about perilous times. In times like these, that's point number one. In times like these, we need the power of God. We need the power of God. What is the power of God? It's the dunamis power of God. Dunamis means the miraculous power of God. Another way to describe the dunamis power of God is the dynamite power of God. So that means when you're walking in faith, you're walking in the dynamite power of God. So no matter what roadblock you are facing, no matter what obstacle you are facing, you have dynamite power. Come on. The Bible says life and death lies in the power of your tongue. So you can either be speaking a festival or a funeral in your when you release what comes out of your mouth. Everybody say, be careful what you say. You got to be careful what you release. You got to be careful what you release because your words have power. We got 2 Timothy 3. Okay, I can move on. Prayer is our communication with God. Prayer is our weapon against the enemy. We are not defenseless. 2 Chronicles 7 and 14 reads, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, then I'll hear from heaven, I'll forgive their sins, and I will heal their land. We've got power when we pray. We have power when we worship. Prayer is our weapon. Prayer is how we fight our battles. The worship team couldn't have said it any better. A prayer is our, when we pray, we drop bombs of mass destruction on the enemy's camp. That's how we defeat it. We can't defeat the enemy in our flesh. We can't complain to defeat the enemy. We can't cuss and defeat the enemy. We can't fuss and defeat the enemy. But when we pray, we step out of being natural and we shift to the supernatural. 2 Chronicles 7 and 14 says, if my people who are called upon and humble themselves and pray. If I say, I got to pray. I've got to pray. You're not just saying words. When we pray, our prayers can shift Pittsburgh. When we pray, our prayers can shift Butler, Pennsylvania. When we pray, our prayers can shift Washington, D.C. There is power when we pray, and prayer changes things. How many believe in the power of prayer?
Oh, yeah.
Come on here. That's why it's important that we pray, not just these cute cosmetic prayers. Come on here. Not just the bigger prayers. Come on. We need to learn, come on here, how to pray without ceasing. We need to learn how to prioritize the presence of God like never before, because that's our weapon. That's our strategy. That is our secret sauce to be able to overcome in perilous times, to be able to overcome in these hard in difficult days, if you're experiencing issues with your family, you need to pray. If you're experiencing issues with your finances, you should pray. Hallelujah. If you're experiencing issues in your community, you need to pray. Prayer answers not just some things. Prayer answers everything. Everybody say, it's time to pray.
It's time to pray.
If my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves and pray. That means some of us can be a little stubborn. A little stubborn. Woo! We can put some things before prayer. We can put Facebook advice before prayer. We can put family members before prayer. We can put friends before our prayer. But it's great to ask for advice, but there's no advice that's greater than prayer and worship and gathering in the Word of God. The Word of God will never give bad advice. Has anybody ever received bad advice? Ooh, how did you feel? It didn't feel good. One thing about the Word of God, it will never fail you. The Word is the same today, yesterday, and forevermore. The Word of God is sure, it is proven. The Word of God has a proven track record. It won't, just say it won't fail.
Won't fail.
You don't even need a receipt for it. It won't fail. It's certain, it's sure. In times like these, we need the power of God. The power of God. There are many people in this room that have talents. There are many people in this room that are gifted, even at home, that are specialists in their skill, that are specialists in their trade. But we're living in times where just talent won't work. There's a lot of people that can sing, but when that man of God, where's he at? When that man of God starts singing, when that brother starts thumping that guitar, it wasn't just notes that were just being coming out of the sound system. The presence and the Spirit of God was moving as they were ministering. You don't need just a guitar player. You need an anointed, Spirit-filled guitar player that's yielded to the call of God on their lives. We don't just need just talent, glory to God, but we need some people that have hearts that are yielded to the voice of God, that are yielded to the presence of God, that are willing to obey the voice of God. Number one was, in times like these, we need the power of God. Point number two, there will never be major development without major devotion. I'll say that one more time. There will never, ever be major development without major devotion. We have to prioritize the presence of God. I know we work 12 hours a day. I know our kids have sports schedules and different things like that. But we have to take time now to hear what the Lord wants to say and let Him guide our lives. Many times, we just want to do our own thing. But our lives are not our own. When we accept Christ into our lives, yes, we do have free will, but there are instructions that we have to follow. And many times we stay in cycles because we aren't obedient to the Word of God. Oh, it's quiet in here. Anybody ever made any mistakes? Okay. Anybody not perfect? Anybody ever had an accident? Anybody ever bumped your head before? The Word of God is a way that you won't get lost. One of the things I like to do just try to put stuff together. And then I have someone come to me and say, just read the instructions. You didn't put that together right. Anybody ever done that before? You tried to put a symbol something and you think the pieces are coming together. But the word of God is your life guide. It will tell you where to go. So one of the things that we have to do is to feed our spirit and starve our flesh. Feed our spirit and starve our flesh. In Ephesians 3:17, it says, that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, that you be rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth. If I say breadth, if I say length, if I say depth, and if I say height, that you may be able to comprehend. What does that mean, preacher? I'm glad you asked. Comprehend in this passage doesn't just mean understand. It doesn't mean just, but comprehend means, in this passage, means to seize. It means to take hold of. In the church today, what's some of you guys' favorite desserts? Just yell about it. Chocolate. Okay.
Strawberry shortcake.
Strawberry shortcake. Who makes strawberry shortcake, baby doll? That you know.
Who makes it? My wife.
Okay, all right. Describe our strawberry shortcake.
Luscious. Delicious.
Delicious. Keep
scrumptious.
Going. Scrumptious.
Out of this world.
Out of this world.
Hallelujah.
What's in her strawberry shortcake?
Well, there's a bunch of strawberries. It's all gooey. Uh-huh. Cream on top.
Uh-huh.
That's it. I get my bib and I go for it.
Okay.
You want some, don't you?
Ooh, I want, that sounds so good. You're going to have to invite me over one day for some of that good old strawberry shortcake. How many got hungry by hearing about her strawberry shortcake? He said it's all gooey and it tastes good. One of the things that comprehend in this passage means to experience. Some of us understand the word of God, but it's another thing to experience the word of God. You've heard about the presence of God, but the presence of God is something that you have to experience. The Bible says, oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Have you tasted the Lord lately? Have you drunk his living water? Have you ate the bread of heaven, which is the word of God? You have to taste and see and take in that the Lord is good.
That's good.
One of the things I love about the Lord is, at some restaurants, they only give you just a can and a soda, they give you a drink and a cup. They don't give you any refills. One of the things about the Lord's presence, he will fill you up as much as you want. And he'll never leave you. He'll never forsake you. He will give you as much as him as you want of him. He just wants to know, are you willing to be available? There will never be major development without major devotion. It's going to take major commitment. God is sending, giving us an open invitation to his presence. Secrets and strategies are being released in his presence. God is releasing secrets to the seekers. The Bible says a double-minded man is unstable in all of his ways. It also says God is not the author of confusion. Many of us are confused about our lives. But everything that we need, instructions and revelation and our strategy are released in the presence of God. He wants to get there. He wants you to take a seat at his table so you can taste and be able to say, the Lord has some good old strawberry cake. So we have to eat of the word of God and not the things of this world. If we eat of the things of this world, then we will only have voids. Everybody say voids. The one thing I've learned to realize, you cannot fill a legitimate void with an illegitimate thing. The void is big. The concern is big. The worry is big. But those answers that will fill that void will only be found in the presence of God. Smoking won't do it. Drugs won't do it. Putting a trust in a woman or a man won't do it. People will fail you, but as you trust it fully in the Lord, instructions will be given, and he will fill you. He will give understanding. My dad, I'm a PK. My dad is a pastor. And he would say this sometimes when he preached. He said, sin will keep you longer than you thought you'd stay. He said, sin will take you further than you thought you'd stray. And he said, sin will cost you more than you thought you'd pay. I'll say that one more time. Sin, bad decisions, not obeying the word of God, will keep you longer than you thought you'd stay. Sin will take you further than you thought you'd stray. And sin will cost you more than you thought you'd pay. Anybody ever made some bad decisions? Some of us are still just kind of rebuilding some things. It will. That's why it's important that we can be completely devoted, be devoted to the word of God. So we can constantly see development take place in our lives. One was, in times like these, we need the power of God. Number two is, there will never be made development without making devotion. Number three, the love of God is greater than anything that we can imagine. Ephesians 3:17 reads, that Christ may dwell in your hearts by faith, that you being rooted and grounded in love may be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth, we talked about that, the length, the depth, the height, and to know the love of Christ which passes knowledge. So, which passes human intellect, which passes education, which passes knowledge, human understanding, that he may be filled with the fullness of God. No matter what mistakes you've made, it's covered as you devote yourself completely to God. You can't outrun the love of God. Paul was saying in this passage, you're big, you're long, you're wide, you stretch the whole universe. You created the heavens and the earth with your fingers. And Paul was saying, allow that to be in me. Paul was praying a crazy prayer. He was saying, let that presence, let that same power, Lord, will you let that fit in me? That's what he was praying in this passage. We have to realize the power, another word for power, is authority. That means God has given us don't need it. God has given us rights. God has given us rulership. God has given us leadership abilities, capabilities. As we yield to Him, that we can't operate in that spirit of fear anymore. We can't operate in that insecurity anymore. We have to witness the people of our jobs. We have to witness the people in our families. We have to share the love of Christ. We have to share of the goodness of Jesus. John 3, verse 16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." How many want everlasting life?
Amen.
None of us want everlasting death. That whosoever believe. Look at your neighbor and say, believe. Loves us that much that he sacrificed his only son. I love y'all, but I don't see me giving up relatives or my only relatives. Wow, that's major love. And love is one of the most overused words in the culture that we live in. We hear songs about it all day long. But until you experience God, that He is the definition, He is the example of what of pure love. When you think about God, when you think about Christ, that's pure love. Woo. That's unconditional love. Bible says, while we were yet in sin, while we were yet doing our own thing, while we were yet living wild and crazy, he died for us. Some of us in this room have made more than one mistake. Some of us haven't surrendered completely. But even with that, he still, while we were yet, and some of us, while we continue, he still gives chance after chance after chance to get it right. That's major love. That's some kind of love right there. He says in Deuteronomy chapter 31 and 6, "I'll never leave you, nor will I forsake you." There may be people that disappoint you, but God won't disappoint you. God won't leave you. God won't let you down. He is always there. So the point number one was, in times like these, we need the power of God. Point number two is, there will never be major development without major corruption. Number three was, the love of God is greater than anything we can imagine. Point number four, this is the last one. With God, all things are possible. I don't care how many failures you have. I don't care how many times you fall. This is the time when you need to get back up. This is the time when you pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and keep on going. He's right there. He said, "Get back up. Try again." You don't have to worry about him talking bad about you. He's right there, ready to release perfect love that you can't outrun. You're surrounded by love. How does that feel to be surrounded by love? Sometimes we don't even realize how much love we're surrounded by. Because sometimes life circumstances can get in the way. We gotta take our minds off our problems and start focusing on the one that can solve them. With God, all things are possible. You might say, Pastor Marcus, I'm just like Peter Carpenter. How am I going to be able to conquer this enemy? How am I going to be able to deal with these circumstances? I don't see how. I got the answer for you. It's God. God is your how. Can we just lift our hands right here? Every limitation, every accusation that the enemy has tried to throw down our paths is breaking down under the power of God. You have to believe that. The enemy won't tell you the truth. He'll never tell you the truth. He'll always tell you a lie. A lie. Every limitation, every shortcoming, as you step into your faith, you're going to be able to do things that you've never done before. You're going to be able to reach the lost. You're going to be able to see your family change. Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ . I know we're skilled, I know we're talented, I know we know how to work our iPads and our computers and everything else. I know we have our methods, but we really need God. We need Him. We need Him in our city. Woo. We need Him. Every limitation is broken. Never say, I can't. Through Christ you can. You have power working inside of you. Let's give God a big hand clap of praise. That is able to do exceeding abundantly far above what we can ask, think, or imagine according to the power that worketh in us. That next verse says, let us give the Lord praise. Verse 21 says, unto Him be the glory in the church. Unto Him be the glory in the church. I'll say it one more time. Unto Him be the glory in church experience. Unto Him be the glory in church experience by Christ Jesus throughout the ages, world, and without Him. Let's give God a big hand clap of praise. Stand, hallelujah. I pray you guys were blessed by that word. Hallelujah. It's a faith fight, but we won. We have victory.
Before our usher team comes forward to receive our tithes and offerings and response cards, here's a few important things happening with our CE family. Do you have a love for people and a desire to help them grow closer to Jesus? If that sounds like you, leading a life group may be a perfect ministry opportunity for you. Our church family needs more CE Life Group leaders for this upcoming fall season, and we'd love to talk to you about the opportunity. Want to find out more? Write LEAD on your response card to hear more from a CE leader. Our upcoming Cape Coral campus has a new meeting space. This new space enables us to have welcoming presence in the community, an adult worship area, and a space for kid experience. Please be praying for Pastor John and Stephanie Hinton as they begin preview services in a rented movie theater. If you know anyone in this area who may be interested, please extend an invitation or help us make a connection. Let's pray that more people will experience a personal relationship with Jesus through this new CE campus launching in the near future. As our ushers come forward to collect our response cards and receive our tithes and offerings, giving is a critical and core part of the Christian life and allows our church family to fulfill God's purpose in and through our church. God has called us to give our time, our effort, and our finances. Giving tithes and offerings to God through His church is essential to our walk with God. When you give at CE, you are helping reach the unreached, love the unloved, and give hope to the hopeless. You're playing a part in helping kids, students, families, and individuals experience the amazing love of Jesus every week. We're asking you to help fund God's increased work through our church by giving generously and consistently. The best and easiest way to faithfully give is by setting up digital giving through the Church Experience website or app. You can also set up a recurring gift that is automatically given on a consistent basis. Thank you for being a generous church and helping more people experience a full life in Jesus Christ. Thank you for being on mission with us to help more people experience a full life in Jesus Christ.
I'm
great service it has been. I love the worship, the message, spending time together as a CE family. You know, you may say, I want to get more connected. And better yet, you may have just made a commitment during the service in your faith. And we would love to hear about it. Please reach out by going ahead and pulling out your phone, scan that QR code. Or if you want to know a little more about us, feel free to go ahead and check out our social media, our website, our app. We have all those available for you and would love to get more connected with you. Another great way to get connected is to subscribe right down here. We have that just for you. And the other thing we have for you is another great service next week. See you then.